All right, folks. I got my main man here, Reggie Ball.
What's up, people?
All right, I've known Reggie for a lot of years, and this is really great for me because I really enjoy talking to the young generation, the guys and ladies that I watched growing up. I first met Reggie in middle school, and Reggie probably don't remember this. First time I saw him, he was driving a car. He had his license. I'm going to say he had his license.
Yeah, let's stick with that.
He had his license. But I've watched Reggie grow, and it's so exciting for me. I don't think, Reggie, your young generation realize how many of us old heads really watch y'all forever.
I do now.
Yeah. I was so proud of watching you play for Tech, go to the NFL, and, you know, become a father, a husband, an entrepreneur. And it just makes me feel good to see all of y'all just start growing and doing and, you know, making mistakes in life and overcoming them, picking yourselves up mm-hmm. and building business. So, Reggie, here's my first question. What was it like? I'll never forget Stevenson High School. Man, I knew y'all was going to win the state. How did you handle it? It's so important.
Mm-hmm.
I remember Craig got hurt, I think, didn't he?
That senior year.
Yeah, that senior year.
The last game. Last regular season game, he sprained his ankle.
Because didn't y'all go to the junior and senior year to the finals or quarters or something?
Quarterfinals, yeah.
Quarterfinals.
Mm-hmm.
How did you handle, because y'all were stacked.
Yeah.
How did you emotionally handle at that age when y'all didn't make it to the state?
It was tough, you know, because we all grew up together.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So we weren't just playing with each other. We were growing up together. We started off at park, in the
right.
park, recreational centers together, whether it be Central or Cab or Redan. Everybody knew of each other.
Right.
And at that time, it wasn't really big, but people could go to other schools.
Right.
And there were other schools that were really actively seeking a lot of us, like
right.
Craig,
yep.
myself, and other players, because they knew within the park ranks
right.
who was supposed to be
right.
projected to be
right.
you know, a stud or whatnot. But we all made a decision.
Stay
we're
together.
Gonna make Stevenson the school.
Y'all did.
So falling short of getting that goal, it was tough, man, because we just knew, just like
yep.
you knew.
Yep.
And everybody else knew.
Yeah,
you
I was like, because I was already, you know, like, man, we getting rings
right,
and everything.
Right. But I mean, you know, you move past it.
Yep.
College helps. The scholarship helps tremendously, but. You know, it was tough at the moment, but
so think about it. You know, you came along right when the internet was starting to come out. There was
absolutely.
Yeah, so y'all actually were kind of free, didn't have to be under a microscope like guys are. But what was that recruiting process like when you look back now?
It was all right. It was nothing. I don't think it was nothing compared to what they do now.
Right.
Yeah, you got calls, you got visits and stuff like that. There was more in-person visits and conversations than there is now.
Right.
But, I mean, it's just as easy to Facebook a coach
right.
or not Facebook, but FaceTime a
right.
coach or to direct message a coach or, you know, you got cell phones. Everybody
right.
had cell phones. Cell phones wasn't that popular.
Yeah,
when
yeah
I was
you're
in
right.
high school, you
no.
know what I'm saying? So it's just the kids are more easily accessible. So, you know,
since it's Black History Month, I'm going to ask you a question. Even back in 2003 when you were getting recruited, you were a quarterback.
Mm-hmm.
Did many schools recruit you as a different position than a quarterback?
All of them aside from Tech and Auburn.
Everybody so else automatically wanted
Louisville,
you?
Louisville, Michigan, LSU, Georgia. Who else was in there? That's about it.
And all of them
but
automatically
everybody.
Said you play
oh, yeah,
another
athlete,
position?
Athlete. Automatic. But I made it early. I made it clear early. No, I'm a quarterback. I'm playing quarterback.
Right.
That fended a lot of people off.
I tell you, I was really proud of Tech. I'm Georgia Tech because I remember I was at a golf tournament and I saw the coach for Tech. We were at a golf tournament.
Could you try again?
And
oh, it's your watch.
Right oh, there. Yep. There we go. Sorry, folks. Every now and then, my phone and watch doing crazy stuff. So anyway, I saw him at a golf tournament and we got to talking. And I told him I was from the Cavs, Stevenson area. And his eyes lit up because he was recruiting you. And I remember telling him, I said, you don't have a chance if he's not going to be a quarterback.
Mm.
And I was proud that he kept his word. And there, but I tell you, man, I was so proud, seeing you as a freshman. Now, I'm not going to lie. As a daddy, I was concerned about you being a freshman starting so early because of that pressure and stress. So what was it like the first time you came out in that stadium like that?
It was nerve-wracking. And I think I recently had, I did a podcast or an interview, and I was describing, like, I was so nervous, you know, my cadence at the line, half of my linemen weren't even hearing. You
really?
Know what I'm saying? So speaking from the diaphragm and with bass in your voice and stuff like that to cut through the noise, I didn't have. We were in BYU, which was, you know, it was kind of a household environment.
Right.
And that was the first game of the year. So everybody was excited. It was pretty loud.
And flying on a plane instead of riding on a bus in high school.
First time in Utah, you know what I'm saying? Seeing the Grand Canyon, you know, for the first time, you know, from the plane. It was nerve-wracking. You know what I mean? I'm not going to lie. But the second game, I got my feet, you know, a little bit more sunk into the grass. And it got easier.
Yeah, so let me ask you a question. You know, as I played quarterback in high school and some in college, and they moved me to up back. But there's something about being a leader, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
I mean,
it's gratifying.
Right.
And as a leader, I was actually explaining this to somebody today or last night. They had dealing with a loss, and they were talking about how much stuff they take on, and actually gave me a compliment for the things I take on. A lot of that stuff you just called to do.
Yep.
And you recognize not necessarily what people flaw, but a lot of people aren't going to step up and do what they're called to do. And you may be overextending, or you may overextend yourself to take on some of that stuff. You know what I mean?
Yep. So let me ask you a question, because people always want to know, they always ask this question. Who hit you the hardest in your 4 years at Tech? Do you remember?
Odell Thurman.
Really?
Yeah. I think it was his last year. It was his last year, my junior year. It was a quarterback draw, but I've never received a blow in that short amount of space.
Right.
And I felt it in my shoulder for like 2 or 3 weeks later. But Odell Thurman was by far one of the best, well, the best defensive player I ever lined up against. No lie about that. That story has never changed. Odell Thurman, even though he had a very short but, you know, highly talented, decorated career in the NFL, but that dude was amazing.
So let me ask you a question. So you know, you go through Tech, do your 4 years and stuff, then it's time for the NFL.
Mm-hmm.
Was that your main focus as a teenager and college student, was to go to the NFL? Did you have a plan B or?
No. My focus was to play football.
Right.
The NFL was within reach once I got my freshman and junior, freshman and sophomore year under my belt. My thing was to get on Saturday morning football and play for a big time college and hear the bands. The NFL was way down the line. I was way more focused on getting to college. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I wanted to play in the major leagues.
Right.
I saw myself doing that. But when it came to football, I didn't even visualize myself making it to the NFL, to be honest with you.
Well, that's interesting. So what advice would you give young folks who are high school, college athletes? What advice would you give them going to college and after college?
Going to college, find out what you're good at off the field. If you could not do football, period, like this, if you can't do football, what would you do? And I know you done heard this 1,000 times, but if you don't take that question seriously, man, you're setting yourself up for failure.
You know what? 1 second here. Yep, we're going good. Let me double check, make sure we're doing all right. Yep. Yep, it's recording. Just wanted to make sure. But anyway, folks, here's the other thing. So you finish, you go through all that, and now you're an entrepreneur, but you had some steps in between there becoming an entrepreneur.
Mm-hmm.
What made you decide to become an entrepreneur? Tell us what you do now.
I really have to compliment my parents on this. And I was thinking about this not too long after we had scheduled this. Because I was just thinking. And we were thinking about entrepreneurship.
Right.
And my mom and my dad, even though they were not together at the time, they were separated, they said, play baseball or football. You do that, but you're not going to work at the same time.
Right.
Because once you start working, you will not stop.
That's right.
And they drove that to me back when I was 10, 11
years
old.
Right.
So I was like, all right, cool. I don't have to go to work.
Right.
You're going to get my shoes as long as I'm right. throwing touchdowns and right. striking people out. And it worked out.
Good.
But in between it, I had to figure out what I wanted to do. You know what I'm saying? I had to figure out what was that niche. I had to read. I had to research. I had to catch up in life. Because everybody else in between,
right.
like after you hang up the cleats, everybody right. else is, they're in their careers, whether they're working or what.
So let me ask you a question. Mm-hmm. What did you find to be, what made you do what you're doing? You know, what? Tell us about what you do now.
Well, over at Effect Fitness, my partner and I, Dooley, the founder of Effect Fitness, we shortly teamed up to... collab, and he has this had this amazing idea for the boot camp class that is now infamous now. If you're not familiar with it, please go see us at effect.fitness.
Yeah, where are y'all? Where are you located?
1995 Metropolitan Parkway in Atlanta, Georgia. We have the apps on Apple, the App Store
right.
and the Google Play Store.
So y'all got an app?
Yeah, we got apps.
Oh,
we're online, we got live classes, on-demand classes. So if you're not familiar with it, Effect Fitness. But I got there by simply just figuring out what was I born with
right.
to make me a millionaire. You know what I'm saying? And they always say, and I've saw that in about 3 or 4 instances when I'm thinking about what am I going to do? Because I can't be, I gotta be able to support
right.
my lifestyle, whatever, you know what I'm saying?
Well, let me ask you a question. Talking about that, you know, it makes me feel good to see y'all now daddies and husbands.
Oh, yeah.
So what's it like trying to be an entrepreneur and be a family man, a husband and father?
Almost impossible.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to lie to you. I rarely sleep.
Yeah. Been there, done that.
And sometimes by choice. But again, just like we were talking, you know, your mind is going.
Constantly.
Because all the chips are on you.
Yep.
Your performance
yep.
and what you do and what you bring in. So, you know, your mind is constantly going. And on top of that, you still want to be aware
yep.
to enjoy everything around
yep.
you,
your yep.
babies, your wife, and all the little things, just growing and seeing everybody, you know, grow as we go.
So let me ask you a question. What's been the toughest part for you so far being an entrepreneur that you underestimate or didn't think about?
Sleep.
Really?
Yeah. Sleep. Sleep, like balancing that time, like because you want to watch LeBron.
Right, right.
You wanna read to your babies. You
right.
wanna give baths. You know what I'm saying? You wanna make sure that you're caught up on their shows so you know their
right.
lingo,
yes.
what they're saying.
Yes.
They're not
yes.
talking over your head.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? So the balancing the time, man, like a man's job is never over. And I didn't get there until last year.
Yep.
Cause I thought, all right, if I get home at this time, then everybody cool. I get home at this time. No.
It's never.
Always something.
Yes.
It's always something.
I always say the most thankless job in the world is a really good father and a really good husband.
Absolutely.
Because we make it look easy.
Mm-hmm.
When I say we make it look easy, I don't think often they realize how much we sacrifice emotionally and stuff to make sure we're giving them all of our time, energy, making sure there's food on the table, there's a roof
right.
over our head.
Right.
And I think sometimes as men, we don't share those fears enough. You know, we don't talk about how nerve-wracking that can be.
Man.
And do you ever feel alone sometimes?
Yeah. that's what we I think generally classify men as being.
Yep.
We're alone. We got to stand at the top of the hill.
Right.
We got to be able to survey, look, and assess, and then attack. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Well, you know, I tell you something, I'm sure you probably have it. I got guys I've been friends with since high school, college, and last 20, 30 years, it's about 8 of us, and we talk, live around the country, some in Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Alan Peterson's dad,
yeah.
No, we were roommates, we're all tight.
Mm-hmm.
But we have been aging together. That's the cool thing. If you got a solid group of guys that you can age with,
because
you're going to go through stages. I mean, we've had people who've lost children to death, divorce, 3 of my buddies got going through cancer. We've lost our parents. I mean, there's so many things.
Mm-hmm.
We've had success in business. We've had losses. And what we do is help each other. You know, we
yeah.
cry together. We laugh together. And I think as men, especially men who going to entrepreneurship,
yeah,
there's another strain because you eat what you kill.
Damn right.
You know, you eat what you kill. If you ain't bringing more people in to work out and stuff, yep, you go hungry.
Right.
And that's right. And then I'm, so how did COVID affect y'all's business?
Man, Mr. Morden, I wish I could give you some long dramatic story about how, don't get me wrong.
Right.
Initially, everything stopped.
Right.
So you took a blow.
Right.
But we were easily able to recover from it because it made us be more versatile.
So you pivoted.
And that's why the app is now available.
So y'all created an app because of COVID.
We had no online presence whatsoever.
Wow.
Before COVID. But when we started doing the lives, we got 5,000 people watching us live. Okay, Saturday, let's get 10,000 people. We get 10,000 people to watch our live class go. And now this is nothing but the trainers doing the class. So
right,
you're talking about
right,
three or four people.
Right.
Three or four people actually right, doing the class and while Dooley's, you know, teaching the class. Then after that, our Instagram account got shut down.
Why?
We don't know. But some unnamed guy sitting right in front of you with the St. Louis Cardinals hat on. When I created the Instagram back in about 2013, I forgot my password. So when we go to talk to Instagram,
right,
hey, all right, so what's your password? I don't know, but look, I can answer every other question you need to be asking, man. But long story short, we got that right. We got present on Facebook, and we were fortunate, man. These people are supporting us, man. They love what they see. They love what we do. And all we're doing is just giving them a workout.
Tell them again how they can find y'all.
Effect Fitness, whether it's on Instagram, Facebook, or what's that, Twitter?
Yeah, it's spelled Effect, so everybody
can. EFFECT.
Because you know, fitness. Some of us would say A-F-F.
Not Effect.
Right. Effect.
Effect.
EFF.
That's right. Effect. EFFECT.
All right, good. So y'all go look for them. But here's the thing that's interesting about your story. On a lot of people didn't take advantage of COVID. What right, I mean, you can't get paralyzed.
Right.
You know, COVID is horrible, you know, it's horrible, but y'all didn't get paralyzed.
No.
Y'all decided, okay, we're gonna do this then. We gotta come up with an app. How do we keep going?
But that was our motto. Like, Mr. Moody, I tell you, like every day in that 400 square foot garage, right, my partner was up. So I'm gonna be honest with
right,
you. I didn't teach the class initially, and I told my partner, Dooley, that's your line.
Right.
I got these training on the side, the personal training, the athletes. You can't take care of class. I got everything that falls in.
Right.
So we had our plan. Every morning at 5:30, that class was going. Every
wow,
morning.
Yeah, you know, I
ball get up
yeah,
every morning.
Yeah, I take my hat off to y'all early morning trainers because y'all got to be ready. I mean, and here's the deal. I don't care how bad you might be feeling, what's going on. You got to be geeked up because you got to, because if your class is going to go off your energy. So you got to sometimes you got to put a mask on.
All the time.
Yeah.
All the time.
It's like being an entertainer.
All the time. Damn, yeah. I never looked at it like that.
Because you are. If you got to think about it, we feed off that instructor.
Yeah.
And you got to think about it. Y'all can't always be that cheery and happy and, you know.
But we can.
But you have to be. But you got to because you'll lose your people. So you got to put on that show and then you go deal with whatever you deal with after the show.
Basically.
So where do you see this business? Where do you see your entrepreneurship going?
Well, we'll grow. We have multiple veins growing out of Effect Fitness. I have the Ball Effect going. There's a green team going.
Tell me, what's the Ball Effect?
The Ball Effect is just a branch of Effect Fitness.
Right.
But it's geared towards me, my family, and what we've been able to do and contribute to the Effect Fitness.
Right.
Because since day one, basically, me and Dooley teamed up, but we've been all here. So it's only smart to start creating other avenues of revenue.
So y'all getting clotheslines?
Something like that. Yeah, so we have apparel.
So I'm saying you're going to get clothes and stuff?
All that.
So now how do people find you if they want personal training for athletics, quarterbacks, and that kind of stuff? Do you do that? How do they find you
for that? Website, theballeffect.com.
So yeah, go to the ball effect?
Theballeffect.com.
Mm-hmm. So if you got a young athlete that you want to have some great training, you need to get with them. But the other thing is, I used to watch Reggie could throw that rock now. I mean,
awesome.
So now let me ask you a question. What was your, I'm sure you got numerous famous favorite plays,
mm-hmm.
but what are a couple of your favorite plays when you were at Tech?
The catch Calvin made, of course.
That's right, because you had Calvin Johnson, didn't you?
Yeah, that little guy.
And what was it like having him out there?
It was amazing. Come on, man. You got one of the best receivers and ever played a game as insurance.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Nobody can guard the guy one-on-one. So when all fails, give him a shot.
So basically, you just said, I'm just going to put it in your area and you go get it.
That's all you had to do.
Wow.
Like, people think that it's not hard to do. I don't care if you are Peyton Manning.
Right.
Aaron Rodgers. If you got somebody that's 4 inches taller,
right,
that could jump 10 inches, you know,
yeah,
more than the
and
than
bigger and stronger,
what, just give them a chance,
right?
And you see what happens.
Good. So when you look, as you kind of look back and look forward, where do you see yourself going in this entrepreneur world? I know you said you're branching out a little bit,
mm-hmm.
but if I was to say 10 years from now, what's the picture you want to have?
Well, Effect Fitness will be everywhere.
Right.
Multiple locations here in Atlanta, of course. We'll be global.
Right.
We have satellite locations. We'll be traveling and stuff like that. I will be at home more.
Good.
I want to be a stay-at-home dad now.
Good. No, there's something about it.
And then we flip it, and my wife, she's writing.
Oh, what's
she's doing comedy.
Really?
She's doing a lot. She was she did a show with Black Jesus last night. What's his name?
Yeah, cool. So she's a comedy writer?
Oh, yeah. Nah, she's funny to everybody but me.
Yeah, I was going to say, you a husband. When she being funny with you, she probably talking about you, too.
All the time.
See, I've been married 38 years,
so you get it.
Yeah, so they say things that other people find funny, but it ain't funny to you because they actually talking about you.
So you get it.
Yeah, so... Now, that's pretty cool. You got a creative spouse.
Absolutely.
And so both of y'all are entrepreneurs.
Yeah. Yeah, but, man, when I tell you that's the best mom I've ever seen in my life.
There's nothing better.
Nothing falls between the cracks with her, whether it's board work,
right,
discipline. We do not spank.
Right.
We don't do that. So she's even parenting me on some
things. You know first of all good wives parent us.
You better believe it.
My wife, she had to teach me a lot of things. And you always hear me say this, though. If you got the right person in your life, mm-hmm. your soulmate, your ride and die, but y'all are friends. See, that's the thing. When you like each other,
mm-hmm.
see, I think people too often mix love up with like. You got to like somebody because your partner, they can do some dumb stuff, but you still with them. You know what I'm saying?
That's liking somebody.
Yeah.
You all right?
Yeah. So mm-hmm. it also... Too often we get caught up trying to get the package, you know, check every box. But if, when you got that friend that you also got a relationship with,
mm-hmm.
you know, and I've been watching y'all, man, it's amazing what y'all gonna do.
Man, it's seamless.
Yeah, I mean, you just...
It's seamless.
And you get on each other's nerves. You know, sometimes I can't stand her, she can't stand me, but we never lose our focus.
That takes time. That takes work. You know, even now, me and my wife, we still work.
Right.
We work on us. You know what I'm saying?
You got to keep dating, keep hanging out.
Absolutely.
Now, how old are your kids now?
Come on, wait, put me on the spot. The 7 and 5.
There you go, 7 and 5. That's a good spread. And you know what? And I always tell this to young couples and stuff with kids. This is kind of the hard part of marriage to me is when you got kids starting to grow and you get so focused with them. You got to be careful not to lose each other or forget about each other because you get so wrapped up in your children. So, Reggie,
mm-hmm.
what closing words do you have for entrepreneurs? First, closing words for entrepreneurs.
Every day.
Every day.
Every day. Every day. Every day. There's no closing words. There's one word, and it's every day. If you're not up doing it every day, it's not going to work. Period.
All right.
Rain, sleet, snow, sick, whatever. Get up and do it every day.
And what's your closing words for up-and-coming athletes who want to go to big-time college and play some sport?
Athletes and anybody. Yeah. I don't care if you're in the office. If you're in the office, you're on the field, baseball field, basketball court, soccer field, whatever, come see me. We're at effect.fitness. theballeffect.com. If you're corporate America, you come in, do classes. We work on physique, body transformations, weight loss, all that good stuff, man. So if you're looking to get in shape, any type of fitness avenue, man, we got you covered.
And that is so important. I tell this all the time. I don't care whether you're an athlete, want to be an athlete, work in corporate or world, you got to take care of your health. I'll be 65 in May, and I can hike and outdo most young folks.
Absolutely.
But you got to take care of yourself because you need that energy to deal with what you deal with every day of
just
life. Yes. And take care of yourself. Mm-hmm. It's important. So, Reggie, I appreciate it. Let's go ahead and wave to the crowd there.
Appreciate y'all, man. Come see me. Come see me.
Y'all go see Reggie. He going to get you hooked up, y'all. And thanks so much for being on. Take care.
All right,
peace.
Y'all.